What should be included in the efficient exchange of information between the master and the pilot? The pilot shall be supplied by the master with relevant ship handling information, such as draft, trim, turning circles, maneuvering characteristics, especially in restricted water depth, channel width, and other data. This information may be displayed at the conning position itself. The master and the pilot should also compare notes on the proposed track plan, the alternative track plan, and available anchor berths along the route. If required, the appropriate form of the master-pilot information exchange may be used. Safe progress of the ship in relation to the agreed track and plan monitored by master and officers of the watch and execution of the orders checked should be included as well. The berthing-unberthing plan, including the availability and use of tugs and other external facilities as agreed by the pilot and the master, should be discussed as well. Tide, set, wind, force, direction, visibility along the route should also be exchanged with the master and the pilot. The pilot should also be informed of the position of life-saving appliances provided for his use. The checklist of items to be agreed between the master and the pilot includes navigation advice to pilot, such as vessel's heading, speed, RPM, distance of or bearing of nearest appropriate navigation mark, ETA at next course change position, next course heading, point out converging and close by traffic, depth of water under the keel, reach agreement on underway and procedures. So they should have an agreement on underway procedures, for example, maneuvers for narrows, channels, bends, turns, etc. What are the courses and headings to be followed, distance of danger areas, maximum speed, in terms of berthing, whether the vessel will be berthing at day or night, the tide and current conditions which are acceptable by the master, minimum acceptable visibility at any point, whether any anchors will be used or not, whether the maneuvering will require the tugs, the number of tugs, the source of tug securing lines, ship or tug lines, the push-pull power of required tugs, communication procedures between vessels and tugs, placement of tugs alongside, crew, whether crew need to be standby or not, and expected time the vessel is to arrive at berth, and any other items relevant to the underway procedures. The master and the pilot should also reach an agreement regarding the mooring and unmooring procedures, for example, maximum acceptable wind force and direction, unmooring procedures without tugs in event of emergency, sequence of running out or retrieving mooring lines or wires, mooring lines whether they will be run out by the launch or sent ashore, or time to run the lines, provision for dock line handlers, determine which side the vessel will be going alongside or unberthing to, whether any fire wires required or not. The exchange form used may include information such as name of master, the date, the vessel particulars such as displacement, drafts, length overall, breadth of the vessel, look type of engine, and whether it's turbine, diesel, and bridge control of engines available or not. Maneuvering speed revolutions such as critical RPM, full speed RPM, half speed RPM revolutions, knots, speeds, everything should be included as well. Maximum astern revolutions, minutes for slowing down required, sea speed in loaded condition and ballast condition, the present state of the main engine, the telegraphs, ship handling information and peculiarities of the ship, any kind of navigational, whatever other navigational aids available and the condition of the navigational aids, the channel on the VHF, the gyro error, so we can go on and on and on. Some of the common errors that are found in the master-pilot relationship is, of course, a lack of communication between the pilot and the bridge team. That includes not only the master, but the officers on the bridge. Then an inadequate teamwork. So recent occurrences have indicated continuing problems with respect to the inadequacy of teamwork. There's a lack of a mutually agreed passage plan, lack of interaction, coordination, and cooperation among the bridge team, and lack of precise progress monitoring by the officer on watch. The officer on watch pretty much leaves it to the pilot to take care of things. Then, although most pilots, masters, and officer on watch agree that improving communications among bridge personnel is key to safe operations, A significant proportion of masters and bridge officers reported reluctance to question a pilot's decision. Fundamental differences are there in the corporate perspectives of the ship's officers and pilots on such issues as the need for compulsory pilotage, limited pilots' legal liability, and not conducive to promoting harmony in bridge teamwork. Often there are differences in perceptions between masters and officer on watch and pilots regarding the need for the exchange of information and the adequacy of the information being exchanged. There is disagreement over handing over procedures. Most masters say they are informative, but the pilots say they are not. Many masters and bridge officers reported that pilots don't always provide information to the master. They also reported that the pilots do not provide adequate, timely information on local conditions. Many masters and officers on watch believe that pilots do not always convey information essential to the safe navigation which is received by radio communications. With respect to the overall exchange of information between pilots and masters and officer on watch, apparently each party is under the assumption that the other knows the necessary information, and if they do not, they will request it. Misperceptions that the other party knows about the maneuvering characteristics of the vessel or the local conditions and the intended passage plan can lead to significant misunderstandings and surprises for the bridge team. A majority of the pilots reported that language barriers sometimes prevent effective communication with the master and the officer on watch. Several reported that language barriers actually exist in a lot of the ships. Pilots and bridge officers disagree on the extent to which the officer on watch is required to monitor the vessel's progress. The pilots express some dissatisfaction with respect to how well they are being supported or monitored by bridge personnel. However, both groups agree that pilots seldom assist the officer on watch in monitoring the vessel's movement. Most of the findings from research with master-pilot relationship are indicative of serious barriers in the relationship between them, thereby compromising their effectiveness as a coherent team.